The Philippines opens a week-long Asia-Pacific summit on disaster risk reduction, with President Marcos reaffirming his administration's commitment to addressing climate change. Our correspondent Pia Gutierrez now joins us with more. Pia, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Tuesday called on countries in the Asia-Pacific region to redouble their efforts to reduce disaster risks in order to secure a sustainable and climate-resilient future. The Philippine leader made a statement as he led the opening of the Asia-Pacific Ministerial Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction. It's a biennial international event which aims to reduce the risk and impact of disasters in the world's most disaster-prone region. In his speech, the president noted that as countries in the Asia-Pacific continue to face increasing threats brought about by climate change, there is a need to strive to create a future where the need for disaster recovery becomes less frequent, all while laying the foundations towards a safer, more adaptive, inclusive, and disaster-resilient region. Let's listen to President Marcos Jr.
Resilience and sustainability must underpin the national agenda of our economy. This recognizes that all our efforts in economic planning are fragile in the face of calamities and disaster. For us, the stakes are existential, the consequences generational, and the policy environment increasingly complex. We must strive to create a future where the need for recovery becomes less frequent, as we lay the foundations for a safer, more adaptive, inclusive, and disaster-resilient region.
Marcos Jr. also called for the establishment of stronger international legal frameworks that will guide disaster prevention and response, particularly in ensuring the protection of persons in the event of disasters. The Philippines, he says, is proud to lead the initiative toward developing an international legal instrument for the protection of persons in the event of disasters. This, as he notes, that as climate change and disasters are catalysts for human displacement, it is necessary to put in place forward-thinking policies that, he says, will create safe pathways for migration and will support those displaced by disasters so that they can rebuild their lives with dignity and security. Carmina, the Asia-Pacific Ministerial Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction will run until October 18th. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Pia Gutierrez, there joining us on the line. Transport group Piston holding another demonstration, this time against the big-time oil price hike that was implemented today. Our very own Johnson Manabat on the line now with that story. Johnson, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. Good afternoon. Transport group Piston urged President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to scrap the old regulation law and the excise tax on fuel amidst another big-time oil price hike on Tuesday. Petroleum products hiked by over 2 pesos per liter starting today, October 15. Piston staged another protest in front of a gasoline station along Filcoa in Quezon City. According to Piston National President Modi Floranda, the latest increase in oil prices will be another burden to public utility jeepney or PUJ drivers and operators. Floranda believes oil companies should not immediately implement oil price increases despite the ongoing tension between Israel and Hezbollah. Floranda explained the recent oil price hike will translate to about 81 pesos per day loss of income for every PUJ driver. Piston welcomes the fuel subsidy from the government, but according to Floranda, this is not the solution to the series of oil price hikes. Piston said some of its members receive fuel subsidy from the government, but there are PUJ drivers who are still waiting for it. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Johnson Manabat there joining us on the line. The Philippine Tourism Department wants to make the country a regional health and wellness hub as it eyes a bigger slice of the $800 billion global market. Jackie Pascual tells us more.
The Philippines is hosting the International Health and Wellness Tourism Congress as it eyes to become a regional health and wellness hub. Tourism Secretary Cristina Frasco says the country is suited to become a major player in this sector because of the quality of private medical facilities as well as highly skilled Filipino healthcare workers coupled with low costs compared to other countries.
napaka-competitive ng pricing ng Pilipinas in terms of its ability to offer health and wellness tourism packages. And most importantly, yung aruga ng Pilipino is really second to none. The ability to exercise genuine passion, care, and compassion para sa ating mga pasyente ay isa sa ating mga napakagandang assets ng health and wellness tourism.
Frasco adds that there are about 250,000 health and wellness visitors per year. Most of them go for medical treatment, dental care, go to skin and beauty clinics, or visit a spa. The tourism department hopes that number could hit 1 million in the coming years. Market research firm and event organizer Agora also believes that is doable for the Philippines.
Focuses on the well-being and on the health of the individual. So this goes for spa treatment, for prevention of disease, and for the treatment of disease. And I strongly believe that the Philippines has immense potential in developing this segment and in becoming one of the world leaders in it.
Agora says the Philippines just needs to continue improving its healthcare infrastructure, push for talent development, and pursue public-private partnerships.
Within the next 5 or 10 years, this number can jump to around 500,000, which is a very substantial increase if the offering is marketed correctly and to the right audience.
Frasco says they continue to partner with various government agencies, including the Department of Health and private medical facilities, to further develop the health and wellness market. The tourism department says the Philippines is already among the top in the region, but it hopes to improve further.
Based on the quality of care that they receive, the attractiveness of the destination for medical tourism, we're actually number 24 globally. And number 3 in the ASEAN region.
There is our portfolio for preventive care, no? Meron din tayong napakaganda na mga facilities in terms of aesthetics, dental tourism, and kasali na rin po dyan yung ating mga wellness tourism destinations, pati na rin yung ating mga spa, yung ating mga nature retreats.
Agora says the global health and wellness tourism market is valued at $800 billion and may rise to $1.3 trillion by 2027. It adds the Philippines can get a big slice of that market if reforms and improvements continue in the tourism space. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.